Journalist says people around the president are trying to stop him from hurting country and breaking the law. The disdain Donald Trump has for journalists is a known factor. Perhaps the reason for the disdain is that he knows they have the facts and that they know what they are writing is not fake news. They may have the best window into the workings of Trump and his administration. One such journalist is the New York Times's Pulitzer Prize-winning Michael Schmidt. He's written a new book, Donald Trump v. the United States. It focuses on two from the administration who stood up to him, former FBI Director James Comey and former White House counsel Don McGahn. Schmidt paints the people around Trump as trying to stop him from hurting the country and breaking the law. Consequently, neither of the two men are still in the same positions. In our history as a country, we've largely focused on how our presidents use their power, how the people around them help them do that and what that says, said Schmidt. In this instance of the Trump presidency, Trump's use of power is so unusual that we have a phenomenon here where the people around the president are trying to stop him. In particular, Schmidt takes a look at McGahn as the most fascinating character of the Trump era. He was constantly pushing back against what he was being asked to do, including when he was asked to order the Justice Department to dismiss then special counsel Robert Mueller. He also convinced Trump not to order the DOJ to go after Comey and 2016 Democratic presidential candidate Hillary Clinton. McGahn warned him it could be grounds for impeachment. Another part of the presidency McGahn was involved in was appointing Supreme Court justices. He brought Neil Gorsuch and Brett Kavanaugh in. But once he cooperated with the Mueller investigation, he started to lose favor with Trump. McGahn found out on Twitter that he was being dismissed. For McGahn, it was sort of an example of the way that Trump treats people around him, says Schmidt. McGahn had done all of these things for the president. He had stopped Trump from hurting himself. He had been in charge of the judges. And I think McGahn wanted to go out on his own terms and had been talking to Trump about that. But here, via tweet, he was finding out that he was gone. Schmidt feels that McGahn was in charge of the president's politically most important, which, I think, is the judges, because they created an umbilical cord between Trump and his base that I believe allowed conservatives to put up with behavior from the president that they normally wouldn't. He saw bringing in all the conservative judges as McGahn's baby. To stop Trump from instructing the Justice Department to indict Comey and Clinton, McGahn found a way to slow-walk the president at the same time that he's protecting himself. He wrote memos to Trump that laid out how this is a terrible idea and how he's advising that he not do this, and the president probably doesn't even have the power to do this. Schmidt even uncovered the memos. McGahn is essentially telling Trump, if you mess with the Justice Department, if you even appear to be messing with the Justice Department, you are going to face enormous consequences. You could be impeached. These cases could be thrown out, people at the Justice Department could quit, and ultimately, the American people hold the answer to this in the ballot box. When he went in and sat down with Mueller's investigators, McGahn realizes that he has to do everything he can to be forthcoming with them. Every witness has to be forthcoming with investigators. They have to tell the truth. But McGahn is essentially there and saying, look, these prosecutors need to hear from me everything first, because I don't think I did anything wrong. And they have a potentially enormous amount of leverage over me, explained Schmidt. McGahn realized, they may write a report that lays out my behavior. I need to be the first one in the door to tell them about anything because I'm in a very vulnerable position. Out of all that, the Mueller investigation ended up with this incredible witness, someone who has access and who has a very good ability to recall the facts and including writing notes in memos to himself between him and his chief of staff that document these conversations. Trump, in many ways, is sort of this human MRI machine where he sort of is able to come and reveal what is inside of someone and what motivates them and what they are willing to do, explained Schmidt. Former White House Chief of Staff John Kelly sticks around until he basically figures out, I can't do this anymore. I can't do it. And I just don't have the ability to continue this effort. For McGahn, Schmidt believes his motivation was a never again opportunity to remake the court. No president would give one person so much sway over the people they are putting on their court. Other administrations had entire panels for this process, but McGahn could essentially pick the judges on his own. To have that option to build the Supreme Court, he puts up with things that most people in Washington probably wouldn't. A few weeks after Trump took office, he asked Comey to end the investigation of his former National Security Advisor Michael Flynn. Comey refused and wrote a memo about it. Later, he was fired, prompting the hiring of Mueller to head the Russia investigation and look for coordination between Moscow and the 2016 Trump campaign. Flynn later pleaded guilty to lying to the FBI and Mike Pence about his Russian contacts and was waiting to be sentenced. Attorney General William Barr redacted Mueller's final report, and Flynn changed his legal team. Earlier this year, he asked to take back his guilty plea. Shortly after that, Barr asked the court to dismiss all charges against Flynn. And the case is still going through the courts. In that sense, explained Schmidt, the president's Justice Department was asking the court to end the Flynn investigation. And if you've watched this story, you can't help but look at that and say Donald Trump bent Washington to his will. He got his own Justice Department to do what Jim Comey wouldn't do in the first month of his presidency.